Well, you are a rocket stroke. You must be expecting something. But I can tell you, you might be expecting, but I think the baby has arrived. Let me tell you about this baby. So few in this generation have been in the presence of the full glory of God. So few, too few. We have been functioning in what is called the anointing of God. But in order to get this world no longer upside down, but right way up, we need the glory of God. I believe that on this show, at this moment, you are going to experience the glory of God.
Live from ISN, the It's Supernatural Network studios in Charlotte, North Carolina. Celebrate with us as we review the last 40 years of Sid Roth's ministry in the supernatural and celebrate the great things God has accomplished with Sid Roth and his special guests, Kevin Zadai, Keith Ellis, and worship leader Jim Sinero. Kevin Zadai died in surgery and experienced the glory of God in heaven. He was resuscitated, and now wherever he goes, God's glory fills the atmosphere. Keith Ellis has experienced 1 minute with God in heaven that changed his life forever. The glory of God will be released to you with words of knowledge for healing. Get ready to receive your miracle, your supernatural breakthrough on this special 40th anniversary and the glory celebration. And now, here's your host, Sid Roth.
I want to welcome our ISN viewers as well as our broadcast partners, Angel One, WHT, GB America, and God TV. We are joined by viewers from right here in America, as well as in Europe, Spain, Ireland, Scandinavia, Asia, India, Africa, the Middle East, Australia, New Zealand, and Israel. Actually, there are over 100 different countries. Thank you for being part of this amazing, amazing outpouring. Now, I want you to get something straight. I have nothing to do with what's going on, except I said the same thing Abraham said. Hineni, here am I, God. I got pushed into everything, if you want to know the truth. I didn't hear the audible voice of God like Moses or Charlton Heston. But I was obedient to the best of my ability. And you know, God says if he'll trust you with little things, he'll trust you with big things. My staff prepared, I haven't even seen it, a montage of 40 years. Let's see what they did.
In 1971, 30-year-old Sid Roth is rescued from the New Age and embraces Yeshua, Jesus, as his Messiah. In 1972, a reporter for a major newspaper in Washington, D.C. interviews Sid, sharing his testimony concerning him being a white-collar Jewish Jesus freak. Sid Roth appears on the Katherine Coleman TV program and on Oprah Winfrey's Baltimore, Maryland TV show. Sid helps start the Beth Messiah Jewish congregation. In 1977, Sid starts a five-day-a-week radio program called Messianic Vision. In 1979, Sid hosts for 1 week Jim Baker's PTL Club TV program. In 1988, Sid hosts the largest Messianic Jewish conference and tour in Israel in 2,000 years. In 1993, Sid joined his Messianic Jewish friend Jonathan Bernis at a Jewish evangelistic meeting in Russia. Thousands of unsaved Jewish people ran to the altars to receive Jesus. In the 1990s, Sid starts a Russian Messianic Jewish congregation in Brighton Beach. Sid has a dream in which God instructs him to write a book of Jewish testimonies. He said that Sid would reach more Jewish people with this book than anything he had ever done. In 1996, Sid begins the production of a weekly television program that today is seen worldwide by millions. The ministry purchases a 40,300 square foot building with two TV studios and offices. The ministry launches ISN, the It's Supernatural online TV network. A 24/7 TV network with original programs, mentoring sessions, and live TV events. Sid holds lectures in the supernatural in America, Canada, in Ukraine, and in Israel. Just in the last 3 years, almost 7,000 unsaved Jewish people have come to know Jesus as their Messiah at these lectures. In 2015, Sid launched the It's Supernatural School of Ministry. We have gathered the best teachers who operate in the various spheres of ministry to mentor, train, and equip you. The purchase of METV, Middle East Television Network, which reaches the entire Middle East.
Every day, we see evidence of people responding from hundreds of nations with testimonies and reports of signs and wonders happening through something as simple as watching a TV program and believing. Russian is the sixth most spoken language around the world. We are reaching them every day with the messages of It's Supernatural. I believe much of the success of the program is due to its unique content and commitment to the message of Jesus without compromise. It connects with so many different people from all walks of life. Each day we hear from pastors saying how much they learn from the Bible teaching and prophetic ministry. We're especially excited to hear from non-believers and Jewish people interested in the vast topics discussed in each program. No other program has been as effective at reaching the unsaved in Russia, Israel, Ukraine, and many other countries. Thank you, Brother Sid, and thank you for all the precious partners who have faithfully supported the most effective evangelistic outreach in the Russian, Hebrew, and Ukrainian-speaking world for more than last decade. Countless testimonies, changed lives, miracles, and salvations have been possible because of you. 40 years, it's such an amazing accomplishment. We know that the next 40 years will be even more miraculous. God bless you and God keep you always. Thank you.
So, that was Victoria Shin, heads the a network, the vast network covers the whole former Soviet Union. And this begs the question, though. I heard her say the next 40 years. I'm taking that one to the bank. I don't know about you. But here's the question. Where are we going over the next 40 years? My staff pulled one on me. We had an amazing world-class prophetess at our for a show, Cindy Jacobs. They pulled her into the studio, didn't tell me, and she prophesied. I don't know what she prophesied, but I'm about ready to find out, and so are you. Cindy Jacobs.
I said I want to just congratulate you on your 40th anniversary. How exciting to be in ministry 40 years. And the Lord would say to you, I am getting ready to release an anointing that is the double. The Lord says the double the amount of souls. And not only that, I'm hearing the Lord say to me that this harvest you have been crying out to, the harvest of people in the Middle East and in Israel, this is the hour. And the Lord says the anointing I've given you for miracles is coming to a double as well. You're going to see double your influence, double the open doors, and double the amount of people that are reached with the medium God has given you. This is a great time, not of coming out of the wilderness, but coming into the promises of God.
I have here Dr. Keith Ellis. Before I get to him, though, I had a guest who is now in heaven. You may remember him, Steve Hill. He was the fiery evangelist at the great Pensacola Brownsville revival. And I interviewed him just before he was promoted to heaven. And he said to me, Sid, I had the most vivid vision I've ever had in my life. And it was so vivid that he commissioned an artist to paint this. It was a regular train that morphed into a bullet train. And he said, fasten your seatbelt, Sid, because your ministry is just beginning. It's being morphed into a super bullet train. And here is what is so amazing. I've had a friend for a long time now, Dr. Keith Ellis. And Keith has such a burden, as I do, for Jewish people and all people to come to know the Messiah. And Keith, you had a vision, but you didn't call it the bullet train. You called it the Jewish Express. Yeah. Explain that.
Yeah, you know, I've been praying for the Jews for a long, long time, and I've been praying that they would come into the kingdom. My heart, you know, the Bible says the Jew first, and my heart has been to the Jews for so many years. And then you and I began to become friends out of a prophetic thing that the Lord did. And I began to dream, and I began to dream about you. And
excuse me. He is the only prophet I know that operates in 100% accuracy when he dreams. Go ahead.
Okay, thank you. But the Lord, he just does so many good things. And what happened was I began to dream about you and about a train. And the train was like, the train that I saw was in the Middle East. And it was a train that was an old-timey looking train. And what would happen, it would come up to a barren looking place. You were there speaking in those places, and people would just come to the Lord. Miracles would happen, and they would load up on the Jewish Express. This happened night after night, month after month, and it's still happening as of even last night. But what has happened is the train has begun to change. It's become more of a locomotive-type speed train, like kind of like what I just saw. I didn't know nothing about that. And it's because God's beginning to do things a lot quicker. And what I saw last night, there were multitudes that had already accepted Christ under your voice, accepted the Messiah, Jesus, and they were lined up to get on board and go enjoy their life in the Messiah. Can y'all give God praise?
Now, here's the amazing thing. Keith sees things in dreams that he doesn't always understand. You understand. You don't always understand. What he's called me up one day, and he says, what is METV? Tell me about that dream.
Yeah, I had a dream. It was like three nights in a row. A lot of times God, when he really wants to tell me something, it'll be continuous. And three nights in a row, I had the same dream, and I'd see this rocket, and it was sitting on a pad, and it was smoking, it was shaking, and you and I were standing there in a great cloud of people. On the side of the rocket, it said Messianic Vision. And I said, Sid, every time in the dream, because I talk in the dreams, I said, Sid, that rocket says Messianic Vision, and it's shaking like it's going to take off. And I said, I keep hearing the words Middle East, METV is what I'd hear, METV. What does that mean, Sid, to you? Because I didn't know.
I knew. East Television. And circumstances occurred that right after he had the dream, it was available for sale, and circumstances occurred. It should not have, but we were able to purchase. It covers every house in Israel that has
a
TV.
Thank you, Lord.
And the entire Middle East. If you have a TV in Israel, it's must carry. You don't even have to go to an advanced type of, where you pay extra. But what God has really done that has caught the attention of heaven and earth is my lectures in the supernatural. Yeah. I'd like you to take a look at those lectures, just a little bit, clip of what is going on. It's so unbelievable. I have friends that are Jewish believers for years, and they say impossible till they saw the video evidence. Let's see the evidence.
in Toronto, Canada, on March 26, 2016. As Sid spoke and gave words of knowledge, 50 people indicated that they were instantly healed. When Sid Roth asked them to stand if they wanted to receive Yeshua, Jesus, 230 of the 240 stood to their feet and participated in the prayer. In Jerusalem on May 2014, where 250 gathered in a theater, many testified that they received a miracle. 248 of the 250 Jewish people gathered there came to know Jesus as their Messiah that day.
If you want to get rid of your fear.
Again in Jerusalem on April 18, 2015, so many claimed to receive instant healings that it was impossible to count. When the salvation invitation was offered, 625 of the 650 gathered in the theater gave their hearts to Yeshua, Jesus. On November 28, 2015, in Ashdod, Israel, 1,007 unsaved Jewish people came and assembled to hear a lecture on the supernatural. 75 of them were instantly healed. When Sid asked how many wanted to receive Yeshua as their Messiah and Lord, 1,000 stood to their feet and prayed with him. Then on April 30th, 2016, in Galilee, Israel, hundreds of them lifted their hands, testifying that they were healed. 1,000 of the 1,045 Jewish people gathered there came to know Jesus as their Messiah that day. Through these lectures on the supernatural, a total of over 5,400 have become believers in Jesus as their Messiah and Lord.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Now, I'm going to have Keith back in a little while. I want him to teach on creative miracles and the glory. Better than teach. How about demonstrate? But next, I'm going to have my good friend, Kevin Zakai. And Kevin went to heaven, brought the glory back with him. And when he teaches about a recent experience, he was taken back in time and saw Enoch and Elijah taken up. And so every time he shares this story, the same power that took them up, translating them to heaven, comes on the people that are listening. Be right back.
Sid, congratulations on all that you have done. You have done amazing things. God has done amazing things through you. And you know, it's supernatural what God has done, and there's more to come, and great things yet to come. And I pray God's blessing. Yivarechecha Adonai v'yishmerecha, ya'ed Adonai panalecha v'yichunecha, yisa Adonai panalecha v'yasem lecha shalom. The Lord bless you, my friend Sid. Keep you, cause His face to shine upon you always. Pour out His grace on your life and your ministry. Lift up the glory of His countenance upon you and give you shalom, life, fullness, peace, all the blessings of His love. B'Shem Yeshua HaMashiach, in the name of our Messiah, Jesus, the King of Kings, and the one who called us and the one who will bring it all to pass. God bless you, Sid. Congratulations.
Hey, Sid Roth, you are amazing. 40 years of It's Supernatural, reaching lives, touching people with the power of God. John and I are so honored to call you a friend. You are amazing.
We will return with more of our special presentation of the 40th anniversary and the glory celebration in just one moment.
The supernatural of God knows no bounds, and now there are no limits to equipping you to receive your supernatural miracle anytime, any place. ISN, the It's Supernatural online network, is now available for your mobile devices and smart TVs.
The message of the Bible has not changed, but it's a 21st century world out there. And how we learn about God's miraculous direction for our lives has changed. ISN takes our anointed programs out of the box and gives you complete freedom to watch what you want, when you want, and where you want.
ISN offers live streaming of programs 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, right on your mobile devices or smart TVs. Or you can choose from dozens of powerful episodes of exclusive programs in our online library. Get ready to receive your supernatural breakthrough whenever you need it, wherever you are. Download the free ISN app today.
And now, back to our special presentation of the 40th anniversary and the glory celebration.
He's a nice flight attendant for a major airline. He goes to a dentist, has a procedure, dies, goes to heaven. You didn't want to come back. Why?
Because everything that you could ever hope for is there in this presence of Jesus. And you look in his eyes, you don't want to ever leave that place again. You want to stay with him for the rest of your eternity.
You told me he sent you back. Why? You didn't want to, I know.
His heart was that everyone would be activated to walk in the Spirit in these last days, just like Enoch did. And so he asked me to come back and activate people. And he said he would be with me, that he said it was essentially rigged in my favor and that I can't lose.
Now, I've noticed this, but you literally live in two worlds. Like my last guest, Dr. Keith Ellis, his wife used to say, Earth calling to Keith, Earth calling to Keith. Does your wife ever do that?
Yes, she does. And also, I've also had a job for 29 years, too. So I've had to live in both realms.
So how do you function living in heaven and earth at the same time?
Well, at times, it's kind of amusing because it's slower down here. So Jesus will show me things that are supposed to happen, and it takes weeks sometimes for people to get it. And so I have to help them along a little bit sometimes. And so I either pray or I start to talk to people and get them moving in the right direction.
You recently had an experience, and that's where I'm really geared to. Now there's so many other things, but where I'm really headed, you had an experience where you were taken back into time and saw Enoch go to heaven and Elijah go to heaven. What did you say?
Well, Sid, first of all, I just want to tell the audience that while I tell this story about Enoch and about Elijah and what happened to them, every time I tell this story, the power of God will come through either the television set or in an auditorium when I speak, because this is an example of the power and the glory of God that's going to come upon the earth. Enoch's walk with God and Elijah's ride in his chariot, the power that took them is the same power and glory that is coming upon the earth. So open your hearts right now and receive as I tell this story. So when I was on an airplane with my wife going to Seattle, I felt somebody come past me in the aisleway and stop right in front of my seat. So knowing that someone was standing there looking at me, I looked up and there was no one there. And then immediately I saw an angel. He grabbed me by the arm and whisked me away. And we went off the airplane. I watched the airplane go behind us. And we went to a place on the earth that didn't look familiar to me. It was a wooded area. And there was an open field. And I saw a man walking on a path. And the angel said, I have been given permission to show you what the powers of the coming age are. He said, it's the resurrection power. And he said, it's the power that caused Enoch to go to heaven without dying. And he said, behold, the resurrection power, the power of the coming age. And he pointed at this man, and I watched him take his last step. And the glory surrounded him and enveloped him around. And then all of a sudden, his last step was in the other realm, and he disappeared right before our eyes. But Sid, what happened is that glory came back and hit the angel and I and almost knocked us over. And immediately after that, he told me that that was Enoch, and that was his last step. And so then he grabbed me, and we went up into the air again, and we were flying. And I didn't know it, but we were going to another time. And we landed, and I saw a chariot pull up. It was on fire. And this man got into it, and I saw someone standing beside the chariot as well. And the chariot took off with this man, and the same power that I saw around Enoch went around the chariot, and the power of God came back and hit us and almost knocked us over again. And the angel told me that that was Elijah. And that was what I came back with. I actually came back with what hit my spirit, came back and imprinted me.
You came back with that. Can anyone walk in that resurrection power, glory that's a believer?
Yes. Before he brought me back to the plane, he handed me a scroll and he said, "Here's your ministry." And I said, "Can I keep it and take it back with me?" And he said, "No, because it's in the Bible. It's in 2 Corinthians chapter 5. He said, "That's your ministry. You have a ministry of reconciliation." He said, "You go and you reconcile people back to God because the price has been paid. Just tell them that."
Now, God also showed you something that is about ready to happen right at this moment in reference to finances of believers.
Yes, back when I did pass on the operating table, he showed me that there were patent numbers in heaven, and it had people's names on the patent numbers. They were patent numbers that were given to these people that had not even received the information yet, but that the Lord told me that they were going to be given all this information, and they were going to invent this patent number, and it was destined for them to invent. And so he was giving that to people, and that was their destiny. And it was also to finance the last move of God.
And do you believe we are at the beginning stages of the last move of God?
Yes, Sid, I do believe that. I believe that right now there's a quickening of the Spirit with that resurrection power. It's the same power that rose Jesus from the dead. It also caused us to become a new man in Christ with the born-again experience. But that same power is also now coming in glory. And when the glory of God comes in, then things begin to correct. And so in the next coming months, the Lord showed me that there is going to be such a correction with that people are going to have to watch their words.
You know what I've been feeling? That as this glory increases, if we say something, even in jest, it's going to happen.
Correct.
And it's going to be dangerous.
Mm-hmm. Right. And I feel like there's a lot of you out there right now. You're going through a lot. And I just want you to know that this time that you've gone through, it's very hard for you. But the Lord wants you to know right now, thus saith the Lord, that your time of coming out is here. Don't wait another day. The Lord says you are going to break out by the resurrection power in Jesus' name. That power, Sid, is there and it's waiting. The Lord said, don't wait another day. So I see that in the next months coming, that people are going to start to be quickened in the Spirit. They're going to be activated. People aren't going to know. They're going to say, who was this person? I don't know them anymore. It's going to be their friends. They're going to change. They're going to be transformed in the quickening power of God.
Mm. Yeah, there's something you said, and I believe it's part of this next move of God's Spirit, and that is experiencing Father God, the love of Father God. Tell me about that, because there's something that is so significant to me.
Yes, so the next thing that's going to happen is the Father's revelation of His love is going to come to the church. The time has come where the Spirit was poured out. The time has come where Jesus has been exalted. But now the Father is going to come in His glory. And when that happens, people are going to turn back to their roots. And that is that God loves us, and He's going to reveal His person. You know, it's as though we have experienced the Holy Spirit and we've experienced Jesus, but the Father is He saved Himself for last in this last move of God. This last one is the glory.
Is that the good wine?
That's the good wine, and He's saving it for the last. Yes, amen.
All right. God has given you an ability, and I have to tell you, this is my heart's desire. Is it yours? To have this intimacy with the Father God? Would you pray that for everyone that's hungry to experience the love of Father God?
Yes. Father, in the name of Jesus, I just thank You that everyone will sense Your love right now, that the glory of God will come in and heal. And I come against all trauma In the name of Jesus, I drive you out trauma. I drive out fear. I drive out lack. In the name of Jesus, I pray for an impartation of the Father's love as you draw your children to yourself right now in this holy time, this dispensation, the Father, His glory shall be revealed. In Jesus' name, amen. There's healings going on right now. Your bodies are correcting. Bodies are correcting right now after that prayer. Don't wait another day. This is your time. This is your hour. Be released. Healing is flowing right now. That's it. Receive it. Receive it right now. This is your time. It's over. You're moving into the glory right now. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah.
You know, I just feel such a presence of God. I'm going to have you back later, really praying, really moving, actually, in the Spirit. And and when we come back, I'm going to have Dr. Keith Ellis, by faith, demonstrate creative miracles in the glory. But we have Jim Sinero here. Jim, I know you move in the prophetic. You spent 21 years as worship leader for Benny Hinn. You see miracle after miracle. What is, right off the press, the hottest new thing that God has shown you?
Well, we're moving into the end time cycle. I call it a Joseph cycle, because it's going to go into some very prosperous years for the purposes of the kingdom to be built. And Haggai said in chapter 2, verse 7, I will shake the nations. We're seeing it happen. He says, the desire of nations shall come. That's our Lord Jesus Christ. And when he comes, he says, I'll fill this house with glory. The former house was filled with glory, but the house he's talking about now is this house. Point to yourself and say, I'm the house. And he's going to fill this house with glory. And when that glory comes, prosperity comes, because he says, the silver is mine, the gold is mine. Hallelujah. And then he says, and in that place, what place? The place where his glory is, there will be peace, that total shalom. Hallelujah. So healing is coming to your house. Deliverance is coming to your house. Reconciliation is coming to your house. Visions are coming back to you that have died. God is going to do supernatural and glorious things in this season.
And Jim wrote the song. You'll recognize it when he plays it. And when he plays this, it opens the atmosphere for creative miracles. Fill this temple. Jim Sinero.
The chorus goes,
oh Lord, I long to know your glory. I want to offer the sacrifice of praise.
Fill this temple.
Fill this temple, Lord, with your Spirit once again.
Why don't you ask him right now to fill your house? Fill this temple with his glory.
Fill this temple, Lord, with your Spirit once again.
Cry out, O Lord, I long to know your glory.
O Lord, Lord, I long to know your glory. I want to offer the sacrifice of praise. Fill this temple.
Birthday. I wish I could be there. It's not your 40th. Why did you get the scripting wrong? It's your 40th anniversary of ministry. Sid, I've known you since 1983, and it wasn't by accident that we met, and it's been a wonderful friendship. I'm so thankful to God for you. You've been a mentor in my life. You've been an inspiration. You've been there when I've needed you, and you've pushed me along in my walk of faith. You're tenacious, Sid, and pray in tongues. That's what's kept you so young and healthy all these years, praying in tongues. Sid, seriously, I wish I could be there. I'd like to celebrate. Maybe we need a week of fasting and prayer today. like we used to do back in Rochester, but I'd love to be there with you. You mean so much to me and so many in our movement and throughout the church. God bless you, and again, may your next 40 years be the most fruitful years of your life in ministry. Shalom.
Thank you so much for 40 years of dedicated God-called ministry to the nations of the world. I'm amazed because a little over 40 years ago, I began my ministry just the way that you did, a Gentile and a Jew, bringing people together in these last days as one new man, the way Paul taught. We're so proud to be connected to your ministry. We're so proud of seeing what God has done in your life. And we know that the days that we are living in, the best is yet to come. The best for your ministry of reaching the nations of the world and reaching God's chosen people. Brother, we love you, we appreciate you, and today we honor you on this 40th anniversary, 40 years of God-called ministry in the end time and the last days.
We will return with more of our special presentation of the 40th anniversary and the glory celebration in just one moment. Divine encounters with the supernatural, signs, wonders, miracles, healings, and gifts of the Holy Spirit should be normal among those who follow Jesus. Have you ever wondered why your prayers aren't being answered, or why God uses others in the supernatural but not you? Sid Roth wants to help mentor you to walk in the supernatural of God to make sure that you receive your healing, your miracle, and your breakthrough. Call now and get Sid Roth's powerful brand new hardback book, It's Supernatural. And exclusive to our It's Supernatural audience, this anointed three-part audio CD series, Accessing the Supernatural, yours for a donation of $40. Shipping and handling is included. Ask for offer number 9461.
My passion is to mentor you to be able to do everything that my television guests do and even greater.
Through this powerful book, Sid Roth will help you find out how to receive answers to your own prayers for healing, miracles, deliverance, and supernatural provision. Discover your power seat of spiritual authority. Receive supernatural tools to walk in God's power. Understand your divine purpose in God's end time agenda, and much more. God wants you to become naturally supernatural. This book is the best of the best of 40 years of investigating the supernatural by Sid Roth. In this exclusive anointed three-part audio CD series, Accessing the Supernatural, Sid Roth, Keith Ellis, and Kevin Zadai each share up close and personal teaching on how you can walk in miracles, signs, and wonders. The series includes Sid Roth's message, which he shared at Joan Hunter's recent conference, loaded with nuggets about healing and dripping with a special healing anointing. Sid prays a powerful prayer of impartation over you. Keith Ellis shares how you can experience the miracle-working power of God in every area of your life. Keith also prays for you to receive your own miracle and that you will be empowered by God to release miracles in the lives of those around you. Kevin Zadai teaches on how you can encounter God's glory in your life. He prays over you that you will have a fresh, personal encounter with God like never before.
The last 40 years, I have interviewed God's generals, the best of the best, moving in every aspect of the supernatural. And I have put their nuggets, their keys in one book. It's like you getting 40 years of experience from so many different streams of the supernatural. I believe the Holy Spirit is going to draw one or more of these principles that will give you the breakthrough you need and the breakthrough in your personal ministry. Welcome to my world, where it's naturally supernatural.
Don't miss out on getting Sid Roth's powerful brand new hardback book, It's Supernatural, and exclusive to our It's Supernatural audience, this anointed three-part audio CD series, Accessing the Supernatural, yours for a donation of $40. Shipping and handling is included. Ask for offer number 9461. Call or you can send your check to Sid Roth, It's Supernatural, P.O. Box 39222, Charlotte, North Carolina 28278. Please specify offer number 9461. Or log on to SidRoth.org. Call or write today. And now, back to our special presentation of the 40th anniversary and the glory celebration.
Boy, there is such, you know, the presence of God is sweet like honey. Keith, I'm reminded, you were such a reluctant prophet. God literally pinned you to the ground.
Yes,
you remember
he did.
That?
He did. The Lord was calling me to speak, you know, and preach and prophesy. And I'd done given him my first major prophecy, which was the Lord had came to me. Jesus appeared to me, and my son was in a coma. And he said, go and prophesy to the doctors, and I did, that he'd be raised from the dead. And he was totally healed.
And by the way, that was the very first book that It's Supernatural published, 1 Minute with God. It became a bestseller. But take me to the time God pinned you to the mat.
Yeah, Sid, I want to go back there because, the Lord was dealing with me after I repented. And, I think repentance is so important. When I got away from God, and then when Justin, my son, went into that coma and there was no hope, there was no brain activity, they unplugged him, I did a lot of repenting. And when I got home, the Lord appeared to me, 1 minute with God. He told me what to do and had to go back and prophesy to the doctors that he would live and not die. Our words, what you were talking about earlier, are going to be very important in this last day. I mean, we got to watch our words, and we're going to have what we say. I mean, that's very important to think about. Well, I was pinned to the floor, and all day long, I tried to get up. I couldn't get up. And the Lord said, when are you going to surrender and preach? How would you like to be called like that? when are you going to surrender and preach? When are you going to prophesy for me? And I showed you these dreams as you were young, and here you are running from me. I repented. Justin got raised up. He said, yeah, but you haven't surrendered your whole life to win this world to Jesus, which is me, So I said, okay, Lord, if you'll do five things.
Tell me one. And by the way, he felt very confident. They were too hard for God. Just tell me one.
Sid, always growing up, you look at the ministers up on the platform, and they were educated and all that. So I thought, the first thing came to mind, I have no Bible education. I just went to church. So what I said, well, Lord, I can't preach because I have no Bible. I gave God five excuses why I couldn't do it.
Right.
God already knows how to fix it all. So I gave these five excuses. But the number one, I can't preach because I have no Bible education. He said to me, you're going to have some education if you'll surrender to me. So I surrendered to preach. That night I went to church. The pastor couldn't preach. He said, somebody in here's got the message. I gave the message. Revival broke out.
Yeah. I'll tell you, when you have shared this on television of being pinned to the floor, what happens to people at home?
They get touched by God. I mean, we get all kinds of...
Has anyone ever been pinned?
Oh, yes, yes, yeah. They say, what happened? You were talking, the power of God just came through the screen. We felt it. Let me just tell you something. A few seconds ago when I was on this set, the electricity of God hit me in the head and went through my body. People are going to be touched by the power of God.
I absolutely believe that. Both of us had a friend who is currently in heaven.
Right.
His name was Bob Jones. And he reminded me of you a lot because he also, when he had a dream, it was 100% accurate. But Bob told you there was a point, and he was talking about the glory. Tell me what he told you about the glory being lifted.
Bob had told me, he came to my church a good bit. We were good friends, him and his wife Bonnie, and we just love him. Bob was such a great man of God. And he came and he was talking about this end time revival that's coming, where 1 billion souls would be swept into the kingdom. Just like no church could hold them. They'd be in the fields. They'd be in stadiums instead of sports events. And there'll be sports events, but the stadiums would be full of people hungry for God. That's what's fixing to happen right now. So, and I asked Bob a lot about that during that time. And he said, Keith, he said, years ago, the Lord came to me and told me he was going to take the glory off the earth for a while, but he was going to leave the anointing. And thank God for the anointing. And Bob said, Lord, if you're going to take the glory, I just want to go. And he said, but I'm going to bring it back. And so, Bob had a prophecy about this time, about 40 years later, and here you are celebrating 40 years, that the glory would begin to return to this earth.
So is the 40 years the same celebration I'm having? Is it going to happen? Did he say in this year would be 40 years?
Well, many people have told me, and they have a book out called The Shepherd's Rod. Bonnie has it out. And it says in there that it would be 40 years. And the way it's going to fall in the spring of this year. It's going to begin. So I'm ready. How about y'all?
Well, you know what? There is no time in heaven That means I think it's ready now.
Yeah.
I really believe this. God showed you very specific dreams about things that are going to happen in technology and in investments in the future. What did God show you?
Just recently, the Lord showed me that precious metals are going to be used in technology. So that we're going to, the price of it is going to go up. You know, I gave a word a couple of years ago about silver was going to surge, and many people didn't believe that. But then we had a surge, and we had another surge. Well, guess what? We're going to have some more surges in precious metal. And so it's going to be a good thing. But I also believe that the Lord showed me that many people were going to get witty inventions of the night. He told me that. And as they put these inventions together, and God's going to supernaturally do it all himself. He's going to, once they surrender to him, he's going to put it all together. And when they do this, they're going to become financially secure and have an overflow. And once they have that, they're going to be able to finance the kingdom, and we're going to get this job done for Jesus.
You know, Keith, we just have a couple minutes in this segment, and of course we'll have you back in a little later segment. But there are many people suffering right now.
Yes.
They're in the wilderness, and they don't even know why. Wrong. And you're crying out to God, God, where are you? God, did I commit a horrible sin? God, we had such sweet fellowship. What word would you give them?
Well, I would, right now, I would give them the word the Lord has been giving me, because I've just been through a great wilderness in my own life recently. You know the story. And so thankful for good friends that prayed for me and held me up during our time of grief. He took care of me and watched over me. And what I'd like to say is, weeping may endure for a night, but joy is coming in the morning. And I want to say that I believe that we're at a mile marker today.
Would you look at someone in the eye right now and say that to them?
Yeah.
You are.
Yeah. I want to say right now that those that are watching, that you've been heavy with grief. You've been going through some struggles. You've been confused. You've been burdened about a lot of things. You can't see the end of the road. I'm going to tell you, we're at a mile marker today in the Spirit. And a mile marker shows you, you know, where you're at on the road. And I believe that what you're about to see is you're at a mile marker, and just around the corner, you're coming out of the wilderness into the promises of God. You're going to have the answers you've been looking for. And you're going to see, God gave me during my time, Isaiah chapter 61. I'm 61 years old. Isaiah chapter 61 and verse number 3. And he said, what I'm going to do is I'm going to give you beauty for your ashes. I want to say today that God's going to give some people some beauty for the ashes you've had in your life. And you know, and God gave me a whole thing about Job, you know, because Job was sitting in an ash heap scraping himself. There are people that are right now, it looks like your world has turned to ashes, but God is about to resurrect you. Your best days are ahead of you. Wow. The same Jesus that got up from the dead is about to resurrect your life, and it's going to be the best days. It's going to be heaven on earth for you people that will believe me. Many of you are being delivered right now by the power of Almighty God.
I'm going to have Kevin and Keith back at this next segment. And they're going to be turned loose, and I believe creative miracles. I believe Jim Sonero is going to usher that in right now, Jim.
Let's worship him.
Holy, holy, holy are you, Lord. Holy, holy, holy are you, Lord.
The elders and the angels bow.
The elders and angels bow.
The redeemed worship.
The redeemed worship you now. Holy, holy, holy are you, Lord.
We worship you, Jesus.
Holy, holy, holy are you, Lord.
worship the redeemed, worship you now. We worship you, Jesus. The elders, the angels, they bow. We can see it right now. We join the redeemed who worship you now.
Apostle of the supernatural. Boy, I get goosebumps as I say it. I wish I could be there, but I'm sure that everybody there feels the same as I do, that we are in the presence of a modern day apostle. We honor, we esteem you. The Bible says, honor those to whom honor is due. You are due great honor, humble though you may be. Love you, esteem you, thank God for you. Have a great time, Sid.
Happy 40th year of ministry. Wow, what the Lord has done in 40 years, it is supernatural. And, you know, of course, you and I go way, way back to when I first came to America. I believe it was like in 1989 when you first interviewed me on the radio. I had that series on the gifts of the Spirit, and that's when I got to meet you. And you would always open the radio program with, hello, Mishpacha, Mishpacha meaning family. Welcome to the greatest family of them all. And so that's when I got to know you. And then look what God's done. And then you stepped into television and now around the world with a program called It's Supernatural. I know how you love the anointing, you love the Holy Ghost, you love the supernatural, and I pray that the Lord sustains you and keeps you, because I believe we're about to see the greatest move that we've ever seen from the day of Pentecost until now. And you're gonna be right slap dab in the middle of it. And so from us, we tell you we love you, pray God's strength on you, supernatural strength, favor, and blessing. And I call you Mishpacha, you are my family. We love you so much. Bye-bye.
We will return with more of our special presentation of the 40th anniversary and the glory celebration in just one moment. Call now and get Sid Roth's powerful brand new hardback book, It's Supernatural, and exclusive to our It's Supernatural audience, this anointed three-part audio CD series, Accessing the Supernatural, yours for a donation of $40. Shipping and handling is included. Ask for offer number 9461. Through this powerful book, Sid Roth will help you find out how to receive answers to your own prayers for healing, miracles, deliverance, and supernatural provision. Discover your power seat of spiritual authority. Receive supernatural tools to walk in God's power. Understand your divine purpose in God's end time agenda, and much more. God wants you to become naturally supernatural. This book is the best of the best of 40 years of investigating the supernatural by Sid Roth. In this exclusive anointed three-part audio CD series, Accessing the Supernatural, Sid Roth, Keith Ellis, and Kevin Zadai each share up close and personal teaching on how you can walk in miracles, signs, and wonders. The series includes Sid Roth's message, which he shared at Joan Hunter's recent conference, loaded with nuggets about healing and dripping with a special healing anointing. Sid prays a powerful prayer of impartation over you. Keith Ellis shares how you can experience the miracle-working power of God in every area of your life. Keith also prays for you to receive your own miracle and that you will be empowered by God to release miracles in the lives of those around you. Kevin Zadai teaches on how you can encounter God's glory in your life. He prays over you that you will have a fresh, personal encounter with God like never before.
It's like you getting 40 years of experience from so many different streams of the supernatural. The Holy Spirit is going to draw us one or more of these principles that will give you the breakthrough you need. Welcome to my world, where it's naturally supernatural.
Don't miss out on getting Sid Roth's powerful brand new hardback book, It's Supernatural. And exclusive to our It's Supernatural audience, this anointed three-part audio CD series, Accessing the Supernatural. Yours for a donation of $40. Shipping and handling is included. Ask for offer number 9461. Call or you can send your check to Sid Roth, It's Supernatural, P.O. Box 39222, Charlotte, North Carolina 28278. Please specify offer number 9461. Or log on to SidRoth.org. Call or write today. And now, back to our special presentation of the 40th anniversary and the glory celebration.
Well, once again, before we go off the air, I want to thank our broadcast partners, Angel One, WHT, GB America, and God TV. Next, ISN live event is going to be on Healing and the Prophetic, March 30th, with Richard Roberts and Hank Kuhneman. When we leave these networks, this program, it's going to continue on our ISN, the It's Supernatural Network, so be sure to stay with us. Just log on to sidroth.org/ISN or download free ISN app and watch 24/7. So stay with us on ISN once we leave the broadcast. It's so simple. Any smartphone in the world, all you do is go to the app store, type in my, it's free, type in my name, Sid Roth. You'll see a beautiful orange app. It says ISN. Download it, because I'm going to turn these two guys loose in the Holy Spirit. And I'm going to tell you something. There is a presence of God here. Kevin, real quick, what are you seeing on this set? What have you been seeing?
Well, I actually saw angels come and start stirring. There's waters of healing under everybody right now. And the Lord's about to heal people. I mean, heal them right on the spot right now.
And so we're going off the air in just a moment, but on the ISN network, you get, just download on your smartphone. Don't miss once. It's a 24-hour network, and it's going to, people are watching this 3 or 4 hours a day, because the river flows out of the ISN network. So I wanted to tell you one last thing. The Lord has blessed you. The Lord, He smiled upon you. The Lord has surrounded you with His favor. The Lord has gifted you. Just receive from heaven. The Lord, He's given you His shalom. That's a Hebrew word. And one of the greater meanings of the word shalom is completeness. What kind of completeness? Completeness in your spirit. Completeness in your flesh. And completeness in your soul. Total healing. It is finished. Your warfare is over, Isaiah 40 says. Your warfare is over, and the flow of the river of God's Spirit is upon you in the name that is above every name, Yeshua HaMashiach Tzidkenu, Jesus. Okay, your expectancy is what causes God to show up. It's not, oh, I hope He comes. It's not, oh, I hope that one of these men of God have a word for me from God. when Jesus said on the cross, as prophesied by King David, my God, why have you forsaken me? And many people wonder, how could God the Father have forsaken God the Son? Because God the Son stripped himself and walked as a human did. And he took all of our sins. Not one was left out. All. And he took all of our pains. Not one pain was left out. And he took all of our sicknesses. Not one sickness was left out. Not one. And Jesus said, it is finished. Oh, there is a river in this studio like we have never had before. And I want you. As a matter of fact, Kevin, you were telling me about Jesus at the pool of Bethesda.
I just want you to picture Jesus coming into the pool. And there's all these people that are waiting for that water to be stirred. And Jesus himself told me before I came back that I was supposed to share this story. He said the church is waiting for the water to be stirred, and they don't discern that the healer is before them. And so this man is trying to get Jesus, if it happens while he's there, to go ahead and to help him into the water because that first person in gets healed. And Jesus said, that's what people are doing. They're waiting for this thing that's random to happen. He said, that man didn't even know who I was there. He said, if he would have asked me, I would have laid hands on him and healed him right there on the spot. But he said, there's no man to put me in. But see, there was a man that was seated at the right hand of God at one time and came down in a body. And he right there could have healed him. And he did. And the Lord said, we're at this point right now where we're not discerning the day of our visitation. We're waiting for something to happen. And the Lord says, don't wait. Just ask and believe. Amen.
Kevin, you told me something that I have felt for a long time, just a few minutes ago, that God told you about something about supernatural languages, about tongues. And Jim Sinero, I know that God is dealing with you on that subject. And there is such a de-emphasis of supernatural language. Who do you think's responsible for that, of praying in tongues? What did God tell you about praying in tongues?
Jesus himself, in person, I mean, just imagine this, 23 years ago, in person, he told me that the number one supernatural thing that you could do was to yield to the Spirit and let the Spirit begin to speak out the mysteries of God. He says, and once that happens, guess what? The transaction goes from the heavenly realm into the physical realm. And I have had people who spoke the language that I speak in tongues tell me what I was saying. And for a whole week, this individual translated, not interpreted, translated from his native tongue everything that I was saying. It was naming people that I would meet within 24 hours, and I did. It was every transaction that was going to happen the next week. He didn't even know. He was just telling me, this is, you know, he would name names. I go, well, I know what that is. And then I would come in contact with that person. He would tell me things. He said, the Spirit is saying, Kevin, he says, you're going into the supernatural. He said, and he told me what name the school I was going to go to. He didn't know that. I was speaking his native language. So what is it that the Spirit is wanting to say through you that's going to take it from the spirit realm and bring it here? And I'm telling you, once you utter it, it is a transaction, and the devil can't do anything about it. Amen.
With the glory that is coming, it's here, really. It's coming. What did he tell you about the next 3 months in speaking in tongues?
Well, he just came to me just a month and a half ago, and he said, listen, you're going to know who's really praying in the Spirit and who's walking with me. Because in the next 3 months, the glory's already here, And in the next 3 months, those who are going to yield to the Spirit and pray in tongues, he says, you're going to see the glory start coming through their life. In the next 3 months, he said, you're going to know who's praying in tongues and who's not.
Keith, you told me when you were sitting on the set, the fire of God, the electricity of God went through your body. But you see, I know something about you that few people know. Do you pray in tongues much?
All the time.
Did you hear
constantly,
that? Yeah. You know who else said the same thing? Paul. He said, I pray more than any man. Are you trying to keep up with the tongues Paul prayed?
Yeah. Well, I went through just a great wilderness in my life just recently, and the tongues, praying in the Spirit, great friends praying for me, church people that love me, standing with us during our grief. It was just amazing how God would just pull us up and help us. And I believe that as what you were talking about, that as people get that, they're going to get revelation, they're going to get deliverance, they're going to get help, they're going to get relief. Things are going to begin to happen in their life. And listen, I'm going to tell you, sometimes we don't understand why we're where we're at. Let me just say this. I'm just hearing this from the Lord so clearly, that the Lord is saying to me that Joshua stood one time at a point in his life where the Lord said, cross this Jordan. Now, Joshua and Caleb had crossed the Jordan before, but he said, cross this Jordan. This Jordan that he was talking about not yesterday's Jordan, not tomorrow's Jordan, but the Jordan that's here right now. It was 1 mile wide out of the banks, very deep and rushing. And many people standing there, they thought, that's impossible. That's impassable. Nobody could cross that. But when you have a word from God, when you have a word from God, anything is possible. And that's why God's going to do great things here right now.
There are people watching us all over the world right now. And you have been filled with the Holy Spirit. You have spoken in supernatural languages, but you don't do it much anymore. If you only knew, your eye has never even seen what is going on in the invisible world. Every time you pray in your supernatural language, do you realize you are stopping the devil from his deeds in your life, in your family's life? You're cutting him off at the pass before he even passes. You know what I mean? Do you realize how important? You're prophesying your whole future. You are building up your spirit man. You are getting ready to jump into that great outpouring of the glory of God that Bob Jones had prophesied, that many great men and women have prophesied in Isaiah 40. It says your warfare is finished because the glory of the Lord is on this earth. You got it? Now, those that have prayed in tongues, get back. Start praying in tongues every spare second you have. You can't afford to miss a second. Do you hear what I'm saying? Every spare second you have. And those that have never spoken in supernatural language, it's only because you have a misunderstanding. That's the only reason. If you are born from above, the Spirit of God is in you, and you need to just be immersed or baptized in that same Spirit of God. Now, it says not everyone prays in tongues, but it's real clear in the church, not everyone has that gift. But in your private devotional prayer language, you do. You do. And I want to pray for everyone that has been filled with the Holy Spirit and speaks in unknown tongues, and everyone that has received Jesus as Lord. And I'll say a little prayer with you if you haven't, so then you'll qualify on that. I want you to speak for the first time. If you say, because your brain tells you, I don't know what to say, so far, 100% perfect, because it's not coming from your brain. It's coming from your spirit. It's coming from down here. Your brain does not like you listening to anyone but your brain. Your brain is spoiled. You've been listening to your brain all your life. You know, a wise man said, a very wise man said, the definition of insanity is to keep doing things the same way and expect different results. Become like a little child. Say this prayer with me and mean it. And then I want you to tell God how much you love him in a language you've never been instructed. And the way you do that is the same way you walk on water. If you say, Jesus, move my legs and I can walk on water. How much faith would that take if he moved your leg? No, you know how to walk. He knows how to do the miracle. Jesus, move my tongue, and I'll speak in a supernatural. No, you know how to move your tongue. You've been doing that all your life, even as a baby. I heard you. Rah! You know how to do it. You know what I mean? You do your part, he'll do his part. That makes sense? Say this prayer with me out loud. Even if you've said it before, reaffirm your faith. Say, dear God, I've made many mistakes in my life, and I'm so sorry. I believe the blood of Jesus washes away those mistakes, and I'm clean. Thank you, God, for paying the penalty for my sin. I'm clean. And now that I'm clean, I boldly proclaim that Jesus is my Messiah and Lord. I ask you to live inside of me and fill me now with your Holy Spirit and power. Now, I want everyone that prayed that prayer that meant it to raise, like King David was told, raise holy hands to God, even you at home. You think I don't see you. You're right. But God sees you. That's the important thing. Both hands up to God, not like this. If someone put a gun in your ribs, you know what your hands would do? I surrender. How about more? How much more God? Now say, dear Jesus, I thank you for your blood. Your blood is precious. The devil is overcome by the blood of the Lamb and the words that I'm speaking right now. Give me a language to tell you how much I love you. I'm going to open my mouth. I'm going to move my own tongue. And I might start out in the flesh, but by faith, I'll end up in the Spirit. Because without faith, I can't please you. So I'm going to move my tongue and make sounds and do it as quickly as I can right now. Come on. So I'm going to move my tongue and make sounds and do it as quickly as I can right now. If you don't move your tongue, no one else will move it. If you don't move your own tongue and make a sound, no one else. I don't know what to say. Perfect. Now start speaking. I'm Oklahoma. Ha 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 ha. Give ye ama ha ha sa ba ha ha ba ba ha. Ha 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 ba ha ba. Give ye ama ha 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 ha. Give ye ama na ma ha 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 ba ha. Ya 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 ma ya da na ma ma ba. Stop. Stop at home. Stop. This is the only gift you can start and stop at will. That's why Paul said, I pray in the Spirit, and then I pray in my understanding. I sing in the Spirit, and I sing in my understanding. I wish you all did. He was Southern. I wish y'all did. Now, you can start and stop at will, but the more you pray in your soup, and if you didn't pray in tongues yet, you're not waiting on God. Take a nice cold shower and tell him how much you love him in tongues. Now, Keith, what's God about ready to do right now?
God's going to heal some people right now. How many believe that? I was praying for a man that was in a wheelchair and he was blind. And I said a prayer over this man. The family asked me to come and pray, another minister. And I prayed over this man and nothing happened. But I knew God had did something. Because it always, you don't have to see it right then. You know, it'll happen if you believe. This man believed and the family believed and I prayed. And I said, God, I'm expecting to hear results. Two or three days later, the man came to me, the son, and said, my father, his eyes opened, the blinded eyes opened, the paralysis left, and he got up and walked out of his wheelchair.
You know what, Keith? I know that you pray for people, and I know this is going to stretch some of you, that have metal replacements.
Yeah.
And the metal turns to bone. Tell me about the last one you got a testimony from of that happening. Prophet, I think you told me.
Yeah, you know, we got quite a few testimonies. But one I was thinking about just sitting here was a friend of mine who had a car wreck, and the truck turned over and over, and they had to fuse his foot together with metal. We were talking about just recently. They had to fuse his foot together. And I prayed for him, and his wife was standing beside him. He could not move his foot up and down like this. Immediately, God healed that foot. The metal turned to bone. And he could do anything, run, jump. We've had so many that's happened to. So, you know, it's just today, I just believe, like you said, the angels here stirring the water. And Kevin knows that if I have a word from the Lord, does it happen?
It happens.
Has it happened in your life?
Tell us something.
Well, concerning what the word that you've had. Yeah. Because we talk on the phone a couple times a week. And we just get so drunk that we have to just drop our phones and say,
excuse me, I have to translate. Yes. They get drunk in the Holy Spirit. I just, okay. A word from our sponsor, that's right.
Okay.
Go ahead.
And several times he says, you know, I'm telling you these stories, but, you know, I'm not just telling stories. This is going to happen to you. And so he's telling about a guy that he was told to go to his mailbox. Keith told him, go to your mailbox. There's going to be a token from the Lord in there. So 2 weeks ago, he told me that. He said, I'm telling you this story, but he says, I'm really telling you. And so I went to my mailbox, and there was a large check in there from someone who has never given me that much money. And so then I told him about it. And he goes, oh, there's more coming. You better get a big basket, one big enough for you to fit in.
That's big.
And he said, this next one's going to be big. And this is what he said. And we started talking. We were talking about, he says, and for some reason, he said February 14th about, he was talking about Bob Jones passed away on February 14th. Well, I had known that, but he said it again. So guess what? February 14th, there was a check on just last week for $16,000. Was written on February 14th, just like he said.
Right, hey, Keith, what's God showing you? I'll tell you what, let's stand up because I'm tired of sitting. Just trade secret. Now, what's God showing you that's going to happen right now to the people at home and the people in our studio?
You know, Jesus came to heal the brokenhearted. And I can tell you that I've really found out after almost 40 years of ministry what it is to have a broken heart. And, you know, I was sitting here thinking just a minute ago that today, right in here, there are people that have a broken heart, that they need to be set free.
And watching on television.
And watching by television. That God's going to set the captives free. There's going to come some deliverance. I know what it is to be burdened down and cry all night and talk to God and pray in tongues for hours and people pulling for me around the world, that my heart was broken. But you know what? God has begun to put that broken heart back together. Can I tell this? I think it'll cause somebody to get a miracle.
You better.
Okay. I met Kevin, and you know, I know Sid. And these men, and this Messianic Vision is the greatest ministry in the world. Amen. And they just have held me up during this time that we were fighting this great battle. And one night, Kevin was with a friend of his, and they were having dinner, and he said, will you pray for my friend, Dr. Keith Ellis? And this guy said, you know what, Kevin, the Lord has just spoke to me just then when you said that, I'm going to call that man on, I think it was Friday, he said.
And by the way, this is a, I happen to know the story, and this is a man that doesn't call people unless God himself tells him to call.
Yeah, and so anyways, he said, I'm going to call him on Friday. Well, Kevin told me that, and Friday was a few days off, and it was on Wednesday night. I was with my son. I was having a really hard day. It was really heavy that day. My heart was broken. And as I was praying that day in the car, my son was actually driving me because I had been going through. So this just happened. And so we were going down the road, and my phone rings, and I looked down, and I didn't recognize the number. And so I just, because I've been not taking calls, and suddenly I just picked it up. And I want to tell you what, tonight is a deliverance night for me and my son over here, Pastor Eli, that's over here with me. Right? So anyways, I pick the phone up, and this guy's voice comes on, and he says, is this Dr. Keith Ellis? And I said, yes, sir. He said, this is Dr. Jesse Duplantis from New Orleans, Louisiana. And I was going to call you on Friday night, but you know what? I got my chair when I got home. God said, call Keith now. And he began to speak into my life because he's been to heaven, you know, all the things he gets. He gave me a revelation. And Sid said, you said this to me. My healing began there.
Yes.
Because he gave me a revelation like I've never heard before in my life. And just this Sunday, Kathy Duplantis, Dr. Kathy Duplantis and Jesse Duplantis were praying for me and even sent something here for me today. But I have been getting better and better and better since Sid and Jesse Duplantis and Kevin and all my friends, my church people, all the people that work here have been praying for me.
Now, but Keith, I have to hear the revelation. You know, I'm an investigative reporter. What was the revelation that he gave you? he gave you permission.
Am I allowed to tell?
Yeah, go ahead.
Okay. You know, the Bible says that as a day, you know, one day is with the Lord, it's like a thousand, you know? And what he was saying to me.
Excuse me, let me clarify something. Keith had a marriage made in heaven, and his wife was recently promoted. So go ahead.
Years of a perfect marriage. And fighting since 1983, winning every victory, one after another. And then God took her home right before Christmas. She was already planning the Christmas. But God, and I was so broken because we were together since I was 16 years old. We met, went to school together, worked together, lived together, ministered around the world together. And Jesse told me, he said, God showed me something. He said, if you live to be 100 years old, Keith, and you got a great ministry, but Dr. Jesse Duplantis said that God gave me a revelation one time, and God told me to call you and tell you this, that when you pass this earth and you go to your reward, Cheryl will turn around and say, Keith, I've just been here 20 minutes, and you're already here.
So every time he'd call and he would be having this heavy, heavy grief, I said, give me a break, Keith. You're all so upset over 20 minutes.
So what I want to say tonight is what the revelation that Dr. Jesse Duplantis gave me, the revelation you gave me this morning, Sid gave me a tremendous revelation, the revelation you've given me, you know, this guy here just loves me, and I just love him. We just love each other so much.
Kevin, when was the first time you saw him in person?
Today.
That's what I thought. They've been talking on the phone, though.
You know why? You started that.
But we were in a restaurant in Charlotte, North Carolina, and I don't even ask him. I say, I have a friend I want you to talk to. And I called Keith. I don't normally do this. And that's how they met.
Wow. And, you know, and we've been, I mean, it was like we're brothers. I mean, it was just amazing what God's done with it. We just have a love for each other. It's unbelievable. But I want to say this today. Jesse Duplantis has some of the greatest revelation in the world, and Sid Roth, and other ministers, and Kevin. And I want to thank God today. I'm going to give you a revelation right now that God himself is about to turn things around in your life. You've come to a place and a time in your life that God is about to do some of the greatest things, and he's going to start with some people as a token right here today. But the glory of God is on their life. What I was doing, I was sitting there, and I saw people that had been having trouble in their stomachs been having a lot of stomach trouble. I saw that. I saw people that's been having burning. They can't sleep at night. Just recently had a man that couldn't sleep at all. He had his bed elevated at an angle like this. I prayed one prayer for him. He's totally healed. He went out and ate. Y'all know what a blooming onion is? He said he went to some restaurant and ate a blooming onion and a rack of ribs. Totally healed. Is there anybody in here got that kind of problem? You have acid reflux, problems in your midsection,
or
in your belly?
Home.
Raise your hands. Wow.
And home, too.
Yeah, and at home, around the world, wherever you're at today. Just get ready for that to happen. I also saw that God is going to begin to heal like he did with the man in the wheelchair and many others I've saw, paralysis. Places like you're numb in your feet, numb in your hands, numb in different places of your body. I rebuke that in the name of Jesus. Anybody know anybody that's like that or have that? How many believe God's going to do that? I also want to tell you, I was in a meeting just recently, and hearing aids were laying all over the floor. I had a word that deaf ears would be open. And all of a sudden, people just started throwing their hearing aids down. I didn't even lay hands on them. And so I want to say that those that's having trouble hearing or need a, you know, you have to have hearing aids. I'm asking God, you know, I rebuke that spirit of deafness in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Through the blood.
Yes, amen.
Through the blood. And then there are people that they have been weak lately. They've been very weak. And they've been going through great trials in their life. I'm going to tell you, you're on the edge of the greatest promised land in your life.
Hallelujah.
I want to tell you that right now. That like Joshua stood there that day, and the scripture says, he said, cross this Jordan. Cross this one. I went across it before and spied out the land. Nobody wanted to go with me. Now it's a mile wide, and it's very deep, and it's flood season. He said, cross this one. Everybody standing there, you know, thought it's impassable. But he had a word that you're going to make it. I've got a word tonight. You're going to get better. You're going to make it. God is going to turn your life around. Come on, y'all. Give God a praise.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
I rebuke every spirit of pain. Every spirit of pain in your body. You that have headaches constantly. I break the power of those headaches. I speak to cancer. And I command that cancer to wither up, dry away, blow away. I command that cancer to go. And your next doctor's report will be clear in the name of Jesus. If God sent you something right now. And I want to say too, some of you are about to have a great financial increase. If that word was for you, stand up and give God a shout.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, ho, 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 ho. Ho, 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 ho. Ho, 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 ho. I gave you a trade secret. Sit down, please. Here's a trade secret that maybe you don't understand. This, if you'll just sit down for a moment, because the cameras can't see us speak. That's not the trade secret. That's just another trade secret. But here's a trade secret. When I speak in tongues laughing like this, ha, 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 it's like God saying, Sid, it's finished. And guess what I was doing? That's a trade secret. Kevin, what is God showing you?
I actually saw myself speaking to everyone a word from heaven. Now, the thing about me is, if you don't know, when Jesus sent me back, he said, I will come and stand on your right side, and I will whisper in your right ear, and he says, just repeat word for word what I say. He said, people's lives will be changed forever. Their lives will be rerouted. He says, it's going to be really easy. It's rigged. It's all rigged. So he's here right now, and he told me to tell you something, and he said, the sun is about to come up in your life, that it's over. Your training is over. What you've gone through, he's telling me, I'm just going to repeat what he's saying. He said, I've been developing character in you, because what's coming that you're going to carry is greater. That if I didn't put that character in you, you would not be able to do what I called you to do. And the Lord says that now, because you have been faithful to me, and you have submitted to my spirit, and you've allowed the yoke of God to be upon your life, the power of God now will also accompany you. And your words will be my words, says the Lord, because your heart is my heart. Without me, you can do nothing. But with me, you can do all things.
So gather up the spoils. Ha, ha, ha. Gather up the spoils. The enemy has ran and left your goods. Amen.
Wow. Yeah, and I feel like that someone in here has been having trouble in their toes and their ankles, and I believe God's going to heal that. If you didn't get healed, yes, hands are being raised. If you don't get healed right now, look, like the guy in the wheelchair, several days later he gets out, his blind eyes open, he's walking. They call me to their state. I did a revival up there. There walked the man around that was in the wheelchair, blind and paralyzed. God's a good God, you know? And I believe some things are happening right now. How many believe something's happening for you right now? Good. Look at this hand. Look at this hand. I believe God's doing something creative. I believe he's creating something good in your life right now. And I believe your next doctor's report's going to be better than the last one. I believe that. Do y'all believe that?
Yes.
Okay. I believe it. I don't even have to go to the doctor. I already know. Okay. Now, the glory is here.
Yeah,
it really
here.
Is.
Hallelujah.
But maybe somehow we can release it. Somehow we can release the glory right now. God says all things are possible. I believe that when that glory comes, it's not even going to take faith to be healed. I believe everything will be instant. I believe that Jim.
Yeah.
Ken has a word for us right
yes,
now.
Yes, hallelujah. I've been thinking of the scripture. Isaiah 10:27 says that when the anointing comes, the burden is lifted. And right now, burdens are being lifted. Yeah. Burdens of sickness, burdens of depression, burdens of financial hardship, burdens of defeat, the spirit of defeat, burdens that people have been held back. The anointing is going to set you free to find the liberty that you need today. And someone right now is being healed of a muscle disease, Sid. Somebody has been falling and you've been losing your coordination, and the doctor's calling it this and the doctors are saying that, but Dr. Jesus is saying right now, by the power of his blood, you are healed. If you'll stand up right there in your room, wherever you are, you can claim your healing, and strength is coming back to your legs in the name of Jesus. And also, a tumor is leaving a body right now. Might be in this room. Someone has a tumor. It's disappearing. Check right now. It's going by the power of his stripes. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus right now.
Okay. Now, you may be seated. I want the three of us. If one could put 1,000 to flee, if two can put 10,000 to flee, what can three do? I want you to, the two of you to stand up.
Maybe.
And I want to start. Let's do 1, 2, 3. Let's start. You pray, and then Keith, and then I'll pray.
Father, in the name of Jesus, I just thank you. As Paul prayed for the Ephesians, I pray for the body of Christ right now, that the spirit of wisdom and revelation and the knowledge of you would come upon us right now. I speak the spirit of wisdom, the spirit of revelation, the spirit of hearing, the spirit of seeing into the spirit realm and knowing our God like never before. Right now, the spirit of the Lord is stirring. There are some of you that have questions. The Lord says right now, he says, at my throne, there are no questions. There are just answers. So come to the throne and bow before me, for the spirit of wisdom and revelation is upon you now. And when you get up, you will be battle ready.
Wow. Father, we thank you today for this 40-year celebration in the glory.
Thank you, Father.
Father, I want to say you did not let us down. Mm. You always promised that you'd never leave us or forsake us, that you would carry us through. We all have a mission in life, and I believe that in the Bible there are 10 wildernesses that are mentioned in the Bible. They are named. And Lord, all of us go through the wildernesses in our life, and we come to the place that it looks like when he said, cross over this Jordan right now, the one that's out of the banks a mile wide. Everybody thought that's impassable. But you know what? With God, all things are possible. And there are people in here and around the world that their situation looks like it's impassable. It's impossible. But Lord, you're saying to me right now that because of this broadcast, because of Sid Roth and his team in Messianic Vision, because of what they've stood for and proclaimed to the Jews, Lord, there's a move of God coming across the Middle East, and it's coming from the north. It's coming across the Middle East. Jews are going to begin to get saved.
Yes.
There's going to be a great move among the Jews.
Yes.
Healing's coming to the Jews.
Yes.
Healing's coming to the people in the Middle East, yes, all over the world over there. I feel the power of God's even coming through the screen right now. Many of them are being touched in their home. They're beginning to be able to move their body and do things they couldn't do before. And I thank you for that, Father. And you know what, Lord? In this particular room, tonight we celebrate a ministry that stood the test of time.
Thank you, Father.
Lord, give us, if you tarry your coming, give us another 40 years or another 80 years upon this earth with Sid Roth. Strengthen him. Heal him from the crown of his head to the sole of his feet. We rebuke any negative thoughts, any negative reports. We bless him with long life and good health. We bless his family, Lord. We bless this ministry, Lord. And we bless these people that have watched tonight, that have come to this auditorium and over in the overflow. Many of those in the overflow are being touched right now. God is healing their bodies. They're going to get better. And as they leave here tonight, they're going to say, man, it was so good to be in the house of the Lord. Lord, do what you promised you would do, and you promised you would do all things well in Jesus' name. Let's give God a praise before Sid prays.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Oh, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Father. God is telling me some more conditions are being healed. Eyes are being healed right now. Migraines are leaving right now. Pain in the fingers, in the wrist.
Thank you, Lord.
It's gone. It's finished. It is gone. Pains of any kind, they are gone. Because I, in the name of Yeshua HaMashiach Tzidkenu, Jesus the Messiah, our righteousness, I bind the enemy. I hold the blood of Jesus against the enemy. I command those spirits of infirmity to be bound and to leave right now. And I say that healing is flowing like a river.
Yes, hallelujah.
Lord.
I am Lord, your healer.
Send my word.
I send my word and heal your disease. I am the Lord, your healer.
These last few seconds, if you need a healing, put your hand on that part of your body. I am the God, he said, I'll heal you,
that healeth thee. I am the Lord, your healer. I send my word and I heal your disease. I am the Lord, your healer.
Hi, this is Joan Hunter, and I want to just say thank you, thank you, thank you to Sid for all he has done through these 40 years of being in ministry. Congratulations for 40 years being in ministry, an opportunity as you have shared and touched the lives of people around the world. But more than anything else, how you've touched my life, how you've touched my mom and dad, Charles and Frances Hunter. We all love you and adore you and appreciate you, and we just speak God's blessing over you. Congratulations on 40 years.
Congratulations, Sid Roth. 40 years in ministry, that is awesome. And I believe that you are going after wisdom, and in her right hand is length of days, in her left hand is riches and honor. So it's going to take you a long time to enjoy all the riches and honor of preaching the gospel.
Hello, Sid. What an incredible accomplishment. 40 years of ministry. Wow. You have come a long way, and God has literally used you to touch every nation of the world. You are the last day ministry. Everywhere I go in the world, from Latin America to Asia to Africa, people are always saying, I watched Sid Roth on television. God is using you to raise up a generation that will walk in supernatural power and ministry. May God bless you, and may God give you a long, long life of health, powerful ministry, and blessings to you and the people that follow you around the world. God bless you all.
We're just so proud of you. Love your ministry so much. And I believe the best, certainly the best wine has been saved for last. Congratulations, 40 years in ministry. Sid Roth.
God bless you, my dear Sid Roth. God bless you, my dear friend. And this 40th anniversary in your ministry, I declare to you and to your family and to the ministry, a new season is upon you. Divine access is upon you. And I am so proud of the work that you're doing with the Jewish people and the Church of Jesus Christ. I am so privileged and honored to call myself your friend and call you my friend. So thank you, Sid. God bless you. And I declare again, there's more years to come. There's a lot of work to do. And we need to bring the supernatural power of God in Israel. I know it's your dream. I know it's your vision to bring the power of God to Israel. So we're going to do it together. I'm there to serve you. I love you, Sid, and happy anniversary. God bless you.
Divine encounters with the supernatural, signs, wonders, miracles, healings, and gifts of the Holy Spirit should be normal among those who follow Jesus. Have you ever wondered why your prayers aren't being answered, or why God uses others in the supernatural but not you? Sid Roth wants to help mentor you to walk in the supernatural of God to make sure that you receive your healing, your miracle, and your breakthrough. Call now and get Sid Roth's powerful brand new hardback book, It's Supernatural. And exclusive to our It's Supernatural audience, this anointed three-part audio CD series, Accessing the Supernatural, yours for a donation of $40. Shipping and handling is included. Ask for offer number 9461.
My passion is to mentor you to be able to do everything that my television guests do, and even greater.
Through this powerful book, Sid Roth will help you find out how to receive answers to your own prayers for healing, miracles, deliverance, and supernatural provision. Discover your power seat of spiritual authority. Receive supernatural tools to walk in God's power. Understand your divine purpose in God's end time agenda, and much more. God wants you to become naturally supernatural. This book is the best of the best of 40 years of investigating the supernatural by Sid Roth. In this exclusive anointed three-part audio CD series, Accessing the Supernatural, Sid Roth, Keith Ellis, and Kevin Zadai each share up close and personal teaching on how you can walk in miracles, signs, and wonders. The series includes Sid Roth's message, which he shared at Joan Hunter's recent conference, loaded with nuggets about healing and dripping with a special healing anointing. Sid prays a powerful prayer of impartation over you. Keith Ellis shares how you can experience the miracle working power of God in every area of your life. Keith also prays for you to receive your own miracle and that you will be empowered by God to release miracles in the lives of those around you. Kevin Zadai teaches on how you can encounter God's glory in your life. He prays over you that you will have a fresh, personal encounter with God like never before.
The last 40 years, I have interviewed God's generals, the best of the best, moving in every aspect of the supernatural. And I have put their nuggets, their keys in one book. It's like you getting 40 years of experience from so many different streams of the supernatural. I believe the Holy Spirit is going to draw one or more of these principles that will give you the breakthrough you need and the breakthrough in your personal ministry. Welcome to my world, where it's naturally supernatural.
Don't miss out on getting Sid Roth's powerful brand new hardback book, It's Supernatural. And exclusive to our It's Supernatural audience, this anointed three-part audio CD series, Accessing the Supernatural, yours for a donation of $40. Shipping and handling is included. Ask for offer number 9461. Call or you can send your check to Sid Roth, It's Supernatural, P.O. Box 39222, Charlotte, North Carolina 28278. Please specify offer number 9461. 1-800-461 or log on to sidroth.org. Call or write today.